Hello honeys, and welcome to today's video. So today your girl is here to show you my result of my maximum hydration method. Basically, I made a video before telling you when I started it and how to do it. Basically, I'm gonna link the video in the cards here. And also, do not forget to click on the bell button when I post the video. I said that too fast. Also, do not forget to subscribe and click on the bell button to notify when I post the video. And don't forget to like this video. Every little thing you think you know, I'm here to tell you it should go. I'm trying to help you understand. If you would just take my hand and I'll teach you who I am. Right now you got it wrong, so sugar, come along and I'll show you who's strong. So basically, maximum hydration method is a 5-step process that you have to do for 7 days straight. So at night, I'll put apple cider vinegar on my hair and leave it for like 15-30 minutes, do other stuff and everything. Then after that, I'm also going to apply my conditioner to my hair, conditioner that is mixed with water, apply it to my hair. I'm gonna sleep with it overnight. Then in the morning, I'm gonna apply my clay before I have my bath. Then I apply my clay for like 30 minutes to 1 hour before I have my bath. And I'm doing other things. Then after I apply my clay, I'm gonna now style. I put the leave-in conditioner and the gel. I was using flaxseed gel. Honestly, it was tiring. Like, I was like, oh my god, no. So basically, honeys, I've been using maximum hydration method for the past 7 days and my hair feels so soft, but my scalp feels very dry. Like, it's very, very weird because I feel like you're putting water on your hair morning and night, you're doing so much to your hair, manipulation, doing one thing or the other. So it's really, really like, has like, I feel like it's high manipulative on your hair and it's not really the best. Also, it's time consuming, you get tired. I was so scared that I would have hydra fatigue, like my hair being moisturized overload or moisture overload. But I was lucky I didn't get that because I was dealing with protein overload from rice water. I was using rice water on my hair because I wanted to get my inches, I wanted to grow my hair. But I'm just here to show you how my hair looks like, basically, and enough with the rambling. So let me show you. My hair is wet. I just came to show you like how it is. I think I gotta zoom this thing in. The method is meant to cure single strand knot, tangles, frizz, that kind of thing, because it makes your curl clump. Like, putting a lot of moisture on your hair, put that moisture in to make sure your hair is, you know, strong. So basically, I like trying the maximum hydration method again. I would say yes, but maybe like once in a year, because I don't know, I can't be doing this regularly. I can't, man. It's stressful. Water is dripping from my hair, that's why I'm cleaning it. Let's just tie it out. On day four, I was like, no, I'm not gonna do it anymore. But I still tried my best and I've completed it. So tell me, I'm gonna be trying the maximum hydration method because my results are bomb. And I feel like it's going to be really nice if you like wash and goes. But I'm not really a wash and go girl, but I was on wash and go throughout the week when I was using the hairstyle. I put some videos on Instagram. I don't know if you follow me on Instagram. I put some videos on Instagram on my story showing, I think it was on day 6 or day 5, I was showing how my hair was looking like. My hair was looking lit. I'm gonna put the video beside me here. My hair was looking really nice and all that. So if you haven't subscribed yet, don't forget to click on the bell button to notify when I post a video. So I'm gonna see you all in my next video. Bye.